Rewarded with knowledge and treasure.
Yeah, no offense, but you sound like a salesman.
But I am a salesman. I am Baruch Korkmaz, expert sales associate.
Just 3 days, remember?
You need something?
There's a lot to be done around the tower. I hope you find some time to take a look at the board.
Thank you. Come here. I've got a...
People are counting on you to help them out. Bandages! Awesome! People love bandages. At least the ones who need them do. Other people don't really care so much. But the guy who lives across the hall from me just shut off his thumb, so he's really gonna appreciate this stuff. Say, you didn't see any loose thumbs out there, did you? When he shut it off, it kind of flew out the window. It would look like a chicken nugget with a bullet hole. No? Well, keep your eyes open. People are counting on you to help them out. Please, don't you...
I just want to talk.
Try listening. The first bullet goes over your head. The next one goes through it.
Stop it, Edward. You don't want to scare off someone who might be willing to help us.
We don't know this arsehole from a plate of falafel.
Don't argue with me. Let him in.
Seems Errol wants to talk to you.
There won't be any trouble.
Do I look worried?
Scared to death.
He's perceptive. Come in, come in. I'm Errol.
Kyle Crane.
This is my niece, Salier, and her son, Aaron. Do forgive Edward, but he's completely right to be worried. We're being pursued by some very ruthless men.
There's something oddly familiar about you.
There should be. The campaign spent a lot of money putting my face all over town.
Of course, you're Errol Asani, governor of the province.
Governor of nothing, but Rise has decided that any political figure is a threat to him. So he's ordered my execution. They nearly killed me once already. That's how I lost my leg. And it seems they haven't given up. A squad of his thugs has tracked me to my last safe house in the slabs. Edward was just there. He says they're searching the area. It's only a matter of time before they show up here.
Sounds like you got quite a problem.
I would pay you very well to resolve it.
You know, people say that a lot to me.
Trust me. What I can offer you can't be found anywhere else, at any price.
And I'll think about it. Hey boys, what are we into this time?
Do you understand what a battery is?
Tolga, you're overwhelming him! Inside the engine compartment of a bus is a heavy rectangle.
I know what a battery is.
Okay, we need bus batteries with marine-grade plates and rated at 1300 CCA or better.
CCA means cold cranking amps.
Obviously.
That's a pretty big battery.
Yes, easily 50 to 55 kilograms each.
That's equal to several large rocks. He's American. The metric system makes him angry.
We will need three of them.
Oh, you can use your brute strength. We know you primitives are keen to show how strong you are, to demonstrate physical prowess.
You think it will attract females?
Ugly and stupid. What else does he have?
How does he live like that?
Who knows? You have your instructions. Go do your interpretation of them.
Thank you.
That's Kareem on the radio.
Thank you. Kareem, it's Crane. Drop your weapon or you're dead.
What the hell's your problem? This doesn't concern you.
Sorry, Kareem, but Errol Asani is my concern.
You're working for him? You're a fool. I was his bodyguard, okay? After everything got fucked up and they built the wall, we got overrun. He got bitten on the leg. I took him to Randall, the only doctor I knew in the slums, and we cut it off, clean. It was the only way. He would have turned if we hadn't done it. But the stubborn bastard never forgave us. So, we parted ways.
So why are you trying to track him down now?
Early on, the authorities evac'd all the political bigwigs out of the zone. Errol told us there was a chopper on the way to take us out with him. Then he got bitten. And with all the shit that happened after that, we missed the flight. But after you turned on the transmitter, we heard Errol asking for evac. And a couple of days ago, somebody responded. From outside. The old bastard's got a flight out, and I want a seat on it.
All right, what about Rice? Does he care about this guy?
Not a rat's ass. This was my business. I just want to get out of Harran.
Yeah, well, looks like you won't be making that flight, huh?
That had already dawned on me. But I'd like to walk out of here.
Look, if I see you again, I'm gonna assume the worst. You got it?
Fair enough. Good luck, Crane. You're going to need it.
Did you find them?
Yeah, I did. Kareem's take on losing your leg was a bit different than yours.
So, you talked to him. Edward was right. You do talk too much. You should leave the talking to people like me, and I'll leave the killing to people like you. However, Kareem was my bodyguard. He allowed me to get bitten, but I don't really blame him for that.
Hey, he saved your life.
By hacking off my leg? The morning I was bitten was the same day they began dropping suppressants. You understand? I told him the antizin drops would begin within hours. All they had to do was wait. Instead, he listened to that idiot doctor of his, and Kareem held me down as the butcher chopped off my leg. Now he thinks I should fly him out of here.
Yeah, well, I told him that's not gonna happen.
You should have killed him.
How about you leave the killing to people like me, huh?
Quite right. I can get you out of here, Crane.
Maybe I like it here.
More likely you've made your own arrangements. Well, they won't work. You've been bitten. I can see it in your eyes. You'll never get past the NCOR quarantine.
Past what?
You see, you have no idea what's going on in the real world. Whoever you think you know, they're not political. And that's the only thing that's going to work now. You don't believe me? Then think of it as an ace up your sleeve. A backup plan. In case you haven't noticed, things don't always work out the way they're supposed to in this town.
Right. If I'm interested, what happens next?
Two things. The first is we need to paint some markers on the rooftop. There's no paint around here, so you'll have to go out and find some. And the second thing is... well, let's just say you'll be leaving here in a better way than when you arrived. Now, go find some paint. There's a construction site nearby. You should look there. I'll tell you the next task when you... first.
Thank you.
come on.
Something?
How you doing?
I would kill for a ticket outside. Who would?
Thank you for saving my son.
I'm really sorry I couldn't save his father.
I could not save him either. He was a stubborn man. Not a bad man, but he could not see things any way but his own. There's a lot of that out there.
Dawood wanted him to have this. Could you give it to Sammy and tell him it's from his dad?
You are a good man, Mr. Crane. Thank you.
Good luck, Salma.
You found some crayons! Oh, fantastic. You're the best. The kids are gonna lose their minds. But in a good way. Here, take this. You'll make better use of it than I will.
Sir, sir. Allow me to bring your attention to a genuine scientific miracle.
Yeah, no offense, but you sound like a salesman.
But I am a salesman. I am Farouk Korkmaz, expert sales associate of Zerg Cleaning Products and Services. And I have a wonderful opportunity for you today, sir.
Look, I don't really want to buy anything.
Of course you don't. And I do not want to sell you anything, except one thing, an idea. You helping me.
Oh, boy.
Sir, I am just 3 sales short of being Salesman of the Year. That is assuming that with all the death and zombies, we'll be closing out the year early, which we will.
Look, I'm pretty busy.
We are all busy. I'm busy. You're busy helping me. But these sales are already made. I just have to make delivery of 3 bottles of Zerp Stain Remover so I can post to billing. Then the sales are complete, and I am Salesman of the Year.
Yeah, but...
But what's in it for you? Glory. What else? Rewards. Yes, some good, useful treasure for someone like you. Plus, you get the Zerp guarantee of satisfaction.
All right, Farouk, let's get going.
You will not regret this. It's a tough time for sales. It's really death out there, what with all the death and so forth.
And yet you soldier on.
Hose them and close them. That's what I say. Salesman would that make me? Sir, sir, allow me to bring your attention to a genuine scientific miracle.
Yeah, no offense, but you sound like a salesman.
But I am a salesman. I am Farouk Korkmaz, expert sales associate of Zerp Cleaning Products and Services. And I have a wonderful opportunity for you today, sir.
Look, I don't really want to buy anything.
Of course you don't. And I do not want to sell you anything, except one thing, an idea. You helping me.
Oh, boy.
Sir, I am just 3 sales short of being Salesman of the Year. That is assuming that with all the death and zombies, we'll be closing out the year early. Which we will.
Look, I'm pretty busy.
We are all busy. I'm busy. You're busy helping me. But these sales are already made. I just have to make delivery of 3 bottles of Zerp Stain Remover so I can post to billing. Then the sales are complete and I am Salesman of the Year.
Yeah, but...
But what's in it for you? Glory. What else? Rewards. Yes, some good, useful treasure for someone like you. Plus, you get the Zerp guarantee of satisfaction.
All right, Farouk, let's get going.
You will not regret this. It's a tough time for sales. It's really death out there, what with all the death and so forth.
And yet you soldier on.
Close them and close them. That's what I say. They are out killing someone. I'll leave it at the door. You'll be billed later. Okay, next one. Next month. Enjoy your stain-free existence. Sometimes they start shooting at me. We should get going.
You know, I usually feel good about helping people.
What are you, the Peace Corps?
Look over there!
I'm gonna kick your ass!
Thank you, sir. You are now an honorary employee of the Zerp Chemical Company. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Here is your payment. Good luck to you. But stay out of my territory. If I catch you poaching my customers, I'll shoot you. Goodbye.
Getting worse and worse.